Creon, we'll start by looking back. How do you assess Sunday's defeat to the Raiders?
Probably a really difficult one to take. You know, I said to the guys to take full responsibility for that. You know, I have to do a better job of, you know, keeping my control, you know, in situations like that. Even though I know, I never verbally abused the referee or said anything. Just argued the point that I didn't want the timeout at the time, but he insisted that the timeout is going to be issued to us. And if for people that do understand, if you do get the timeout, the ball gets advanced, which means 14 seconds come off the shot clock. So we really needed those two timeouts for the game. But obviously, I ended up getting the technical foul, so I wasn't there to help the team after they had made the free throws. So, you know, it's something that I've got to learn to do better. Kind of like probably try and sit on my hands a little bit, you know, take the passion out of it a little bit and be there for the guys.
Did it feel like another game that got away, that something we maybe should have got something from?
Very much so. You know, it's three. We 0-3 right now, and everybody's seen that we right up until the fourth quarter or last seconds of a game, we right there, you know, and winning's a habit, and we've got to find a way to get over that finish line. And I think once we do manage to do that, it will help us in future games.
Now, we head to the Copper Box as defending All-Stars champions. You looking forward to defending the title?
Yeah, I think, we probably never earned the right to be there by our league status last year, but obviously as returning as champions, we've got our opportunity to be at a very prestigious event. Lots of clubs look at the format. It's exciting for the fans, you know, difficult for the coaches and the players, but it's a great opportunity, a great day out, you know, playing in front of sky cameras is always a big thing also. So really looking forward to it, and you know, we'll approach it with hopefully the same way we did last year, and have the same results.
With that different format, are there any keys to success that you identified last year that can stand you in good stead this time?
I think it's just run and gun, you know, really fast up-tempo basketball. We are a very small team this year, and that's what we want to try and do. I don't think we've run as well as we'd like to in a regular basketball game. So hopefully with the shorter shot clock, it will release guys and allow them to show their true ability in an open court. So nothing special going to be focused on, but, you know, just trying to play some good, hard, up-tempo basketball.
But do you think with that pace in the team, the way you've set them up, and the fact that the three-pointers have been a feature of Scorcher's play so far, do you think that might be to your advantage over other teams?
I think so. You know, the saying in basketball, you know, you live by the three, you die by the three. So hopefully, you know, we'll be doing a lot of living by the three and be making them, and then we'll be absolutely fine. You know, Henry Wilkins has been great for us. He's shooting touches with him, and so long may that continue. Skylar White's been shooting the ball really well also. Teo chips in with his threes, and obviously when we do have Kalen on the court, he also does stuff, and Adrian Kinu. So across the board, we do have some good shooters. But, you know, the key will be getting defensive stops and then getting out in transition.
It's Royals first up. It's difficult to assess how the day is going to develop with other results, clearly. But is it just the key is just a fast start and build momentum?
I think so. You know, last year we lost our first game, which put a little bit of pressure on us going into our second game. I think we'd rather be in a position where we win our first game and you know that the following game helps us advance. So a key thing for us is just taking one game at a time. And when we go up against, you know, I think London Royals have proven, you know, with the addition of Andrew Lawrence, they got the Lithuanian twins that have come in. They are a team to be reckoned with and are probably one of the better teams in our league. So we'll embrace our underdog title again and, you know, try and cause some upsets.
Excellent. We're looking forward to it. We'll see you at the Copper Box.
Yes, thank you.